Hey everyone, Holden here with Gold Plating Services. Today we're going to be taking an in-depth look at our chrome stripping solution so you can be successful when using it. What we will be covering in this video is when to use chrome stripping solution, items needed to use the solution properly, how to use the solution, and unique attributes of chrome stripping solution. Chrome is a very difficult surface to plate onto. Even if gold plate goes onto the surface, it will usually not adhere. Therefore, removing the chrome finish from the chrome-plated item is the first step in the plating process. Chrome stripping solution is designed to effectively and easily remove the chrome finish to reveal a nickel surface underneath, which is a much easier surface to plate onto. Anytime you have a chrome-plated item you want to electroplate, chrome stripping solution is what you need. Sometimes it can be difficult to know whether or not your item is chrome-plated, as different finishes can look very similar to each other. You can use the chrome stripping solution and observe the way it reacts to your items to help determine what they are made of. When something is chrome, the solution turns yellow. Please refer to the chart titled Guide to Help Identify Metal Types that can be found underneath the Tech Support tab on our website. To use the chrome stripping solution effectively, you'll need a machine or power supply that is capable of functioning in chrome stripping mode, such as our Universal Plater Chrome Edition or our ProLab Chrome Stripping Module. You will also need stainless steel anodes for bath plating and a stainless steel bit for brush plating, with a voltage range of 6 to 12 volts. Chrome stripping solution works at room temperature and needs to be used for as long as it takes for all the chrome to be removed from your surface so it can become hydrophilic, or wet out. For a more thorough understanding of what it means for the surface to become hydrophilic, please refer to our video on wetting out for brush plating and bath plating. Make sure to prepare your items before beginning the plating process. This means removing any marks or scuffs, then polishing if needed, and then washing with warm soapy water. If you're using a brush plating setup, then as you begin to apply the chrome stripping solution to your item, you will be able to visually see the chrome coming off as the sleeve turns a dark yellow color and the solution dripping off from the item also darkens with a yellow color. You will also be able to see the difference in color between the chrome plate, which has a bluish undertone, and the underlying nickel plate, which is a bit darker with a more yellow undertone. But just because you see a difference in color, it doesn't mean that the chrome is completely removed. You cannot overstrip the chrome because the chrome stripping solution will only remove chrome. It will not damage the underlying nickel. Based on our experience providing support to customers, we recommend that once you think the chrome is removed, to continue chrome stripping the item for another 15 to 30 seconds or more if needed. If the chrome is not completely removed and you move on with the plating process, you will end up with a hazy gold plate in that area. You will need to polish off the gold and start over again. If you have a bath plating setup, you won't be able to visually see the chrome stripping process happening as clearly, but as more nickel is exposed, the fumes from the solution will increase. After chrome stripping, rinse off your item and inspect it for water beading and water breaks. If the item is not wet out or hydrophilic, then start the chrome stripping again. With use, chrome stripping solution will become over-concentrated with chrome. This can cause the solution to be highly conductive and will most likely cause your machine to short out. This is normal and is an important function of your machine. As the chrome in the solution becomes more concentrated, the machine will start to pull more amps, and when the solution gets too conductive, it will pull over the available amps with the power supply that you are using, and the machine, as a safety measure, will short out. Once the machine has cooled down or reset, it will come back on, but it will continue to short out until you address the overconcentration. You can fix this situation by diluting your solution with distilled water or replacing it with fresh solution. Also, if you are brush plating, rinse your used sleeve out with distilled water to remove the used solution it has absorbed. Our chrome machine comes with a 12 volt 10 amp power supply. Our ProLab tower comes with a 20 to 60 amp power supply and is able to handle more current. Having more amperage is not always the answer though. Too much amperage for a long time will cause your sleeve, anode, rack, or even the part to get excessively hot. This can lead to burning the surface of your part. Chrome stripping solution can perform the same functions as electrocleaner when it is used in normal plating mode. It is able to cause the surface of your non-chrome item to wet out. The ProLab chrome stripping tower always remains in chrome stripping mode, so it cannot be used in place of electrocleaner. But the Universal Plater Chrome Edition has a switch that allows it to alternate between the two settings. If you are plating a non-chrome item with the Universal Plater Chrome Edition, simply leave the machine in normal plating mode for all the steps. And the chrome stripping solution will clean your item and create a hydrophilic surface just like ElectroCleaner would. Note that while chrome stripping solution can perform the same functions as ElectroCleaner when used in the proper mode, ElectroCleaner is not capable of performing the same functions as chrome stripping solution in that it cannot be used to strip chrome. Chrome stripping solution can cause more corrosion on your machine parts, such as the ports, leads, and bus bars. As corrosion builds up, it can limit or even prevent conductivity, damage the machine accessories, and potentially damage electrical components within the machine. Our warranties do not cover damage caused by corrosion. It is important to keep your workspace clean when using the chrome stripping solution to support the longevity of your equipment. After unplugging your power supply, we recommend cleaning your machine, accessories, and workspace with paper towels dampened with water, and use sandpaper or wire brushes to remove corrosion. You can find links to videos on our equipment repair page on our website that has helpful information about maintaining and troubleshooting your machine. Chrome stripping solution cannot be shipped internationally due to the shipping regulations. It is only available within the continental US and Canada and must be shipped via UPS Ground. If you're interested in this product and you're outside of the continental US and Canada, please contact us via phone or email and we'll be happy to assist you. Thank you guys so much for watching. We hope this video on our chrome stripping solution has helped you be more successful with electroplating. If you do have any additional questions, feel free to reach out to us. And again, thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.